Today we will see what is priority scheduling algorithm. To understand the concept of priority scheduling, let's take a general example. Suppose you are playing a music player in your mobile and a call is coming at that time. Then what happens? Your phone will start ringing and your music player will get stopped or paused at that particular time. Because the priority of your call is higher than your music player. Now we will see some points of priority scheduling algorithm. The first point is, in scheduling, priorities are generally some fixed range of number. For example, 0 to 9 means when a process arrived, system will assign priority in the range of numbers 0 to 9 or between 0 to any number. Second, system can use low number as low priority or low number as higher priority because it's not generally fixed which number will use as lower priority or higher priority. So it depends on system that it can use low number as lower priority or low number as high priority. The third point is, priority scheduling can be either primitive or non-primitive. It means if a process running with CPU and a higher priority process arrive in ready queue, if we interrupt that process, then scheduling algorithm is known as a primitive scheduling algorithm. If you simply put the higher priority process in the head of the ready queue, then it is non-primitive priority scheduling algorithm. Let's see the example of priority scheduling algorithm. Here we have 5 processes P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. Their burst time are given 10, 1, 2, 1, 5. It is given in milliseconds. And their priorities are 3, 1, 4, 5, 2 and the arrival time of the process are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. It is also given in millisecond. Here we note that there is one more condition, that is lower number has higher priority. It means we consider lower number as higher priority process and we will serve the lower number process first. We will first solve non-primitive priority scheduling algorithm. In non-primitive scheduling algorithm, a process will not release the CPU till it completes its job. Here we are using non-primitive priority scheduling algorithm. Let's solve this numerical. Now you see the process P1 arrived at 0 millisecond. At that time, no other process are in ready queue because P2, P3, P4, P5 will arrive in 1, 2, 3 and 4 millisecond. So we serve the process P1. Process P1 will get the CPU. As we know that CPU time always start at 0 and P1 arrived at 0. So P1 get the CPU for 10 milliseconds because we are using non-primitive priority scheduling algorithm and at time 0 we don't have any process for comparison. So P1 get the CPU for 10 milliseconds. Now we can see that in ready queue we have 4 processes P2, P3, P4 and P5. All are arrived in ready queue. So we can compare between their priorities. Here we know we are considering lower number as higher priority. So P2 has lower number. P2 will get the CPU. It needs only 1 millisecond to complete its job. So it will complete the job in 11 milliseconds.
Now, P2 has lower priority, P2 has lower number, so it is next highest priority process. So it will get the CPU for 5 millisecond as it needed 5 millisecond to complete its job. So the total time of CPU will be 16. Now, process P3 has lower number. It needs 2 millisecond of CPU to complete its job. So the time will be 18. Now, last, P4 get the CPU. It needs only 1 millisecond. So the time, total time will be 19. You can calculate the average waiting time. Here, process P1 arrived at 0 and it get the CPU at 0 millisecond. So the waiting time of process P1 will be 0. Process P2 arrived at 1 millisecond but get the CPU at 10 millisecond. So the waiting time of process P2 will be 10 minus 1. The process P3 arrived at 2 millisecond but get the CPU at 16 millisecond. So the waiting time of process P3 will be 16 minus 2. Process P4 arrived at 3 millisecond but get the CPU at 18 millisecond. So 18 minus 3 will be the waiting time of process P4. Process P5 arrived at 4 millisecond but get the CPU at 11 millisecond. So 11 minus 4 will be waiting time of process P5. Now divide it by 5, you will get the average waiting time 0 plus 9 plus 14 plus 15 plus 6 divided by 5 is equal to 44 divided by 5 is equal to 8.8 millisecond will be the average waiting time of this numerical.